where grace is found is where you are, and where you are, Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. Temptation comes my way. When I cannot stand or fall on you, Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Won't you teach my soul to rise to you? When temptation comes my way. I'll fall on you. every thought before I think it.
Give it all. then I saw in the right hand of him who sat on the throne a scroll with writing on both sides and sealed with seven seals. And I saw a mighty angel proclaiming in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to break the seals and open the scroll?" But no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth could open the scroll or even look inside. I wept and wept because no one was found who was worthy to open the scroll or look inside. Then one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed. He is able to open the scroll and its seven seals." And then I saw a lamb looking as if it had been slain, standing in the center of the throne, encircled by four living creatures and the elders. He had seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all the earth. He came and took the scroll from the right hand of him who sat on the throne. And when he had taken it, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each one had a harp, and they were holding golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song. "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slain, and with your blood you purchased men for God from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth." Then I looked and heard the voice of many angels numbering thousands upon thousands and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice, they sang, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them singing, "To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever." And the four living creatures said, "Amen." And the elders fell down and worshiped.
Oh.
His blood, we have been ransomed. Oh, by His blood, we have been bought. Every tribe and language, every people and hearts explode with praises. praise, God, of singing your praise, God. Oh, our lips will never tire, our lips will never tire of singing your praise, singing your praise. Oh, our lips will never tire, our lips will never tire of singing your praise. Tired of singing your praise, singing your praise. Our lips will never tire, our lips will never tire of singing your praise, singing your praise. Our lips will never tire, our lips will never tire. Singing your praise, singing your praise, praise, singing your praise, praise, singing your praise, oh praise, singing your praise, sing.
Revelation 5, verses 9 through 14. And they sang a new song. You're worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you are slain. And with your blood you purchased men for God from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth. Then I looked and heard the voice of many angels numbering thousands upon thousands and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice, they sang, worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise. Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them singing, to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever. And the four living creatures said, amen. And the elders fell down and worshiped. Jesus, you are worthy of our worship. You are worthy of our surrender. You're worthy of our sacrifice and our lives being offered unto you on your altar. You are worthy of everything that we hold dear. We thank you, God. You're a God who commands our praise. You're a God who commands our worship. Let everything that has breath praise God. the Lord. May we see not just the angels and the 24 elders around your throne giving you the worship, Lord God, but all heaven and all earth, every living creature here on earth. Lord God, may we surround you with the worship, the praise, the exaltation that you deserve. We thank you, God. You are a God who sits on the throne, who reigns over all the earth. You are a God who is glorious beyond our understanding. You're a God who is majestic, who's mighty, and who's powerful. We give you glory. We give you praise, God.
And don't There's only one found worthy, only one found worthy. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. Oh, his name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus.
Sing your name.
give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing.
And
crowns before the Lamb. of it all. You are worthy of it all, Jesus. For from you are all things, and to you are all things, and you deserve the glory. You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. Day and night, day and night. You are worthy of it all. you are all things, and you deserve the glory. Sing it out again, you are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things, and you deserve the glory.
Thank you.
praises arise, praises arise, our praises arise, oh, to you, oh, hey, 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 I waited patiently upon the Lord, and He inclined and heard my cry. He pulled me up out of the miry clay. He set my feet upon a rock. He gave me beauty for ashes, joy for my morning, and praise for heaviness. He put a new song in my mouth, and a crown upon my head. He gave me life forevermore. It's been so good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. He's been so good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. He's been so good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. I will not forget your goodness, your kindness towards me, oh God. And how I waited patiently on the Lord, and He inclined and heard my cry. He pulled me up out of the miry clay. Oh, He set my feet upon a rock. He gave me beauty for ashes and joy for my mourning, and praise for heaviness. He put a new song in my mouth, and a crown upon my head. He gave me life forevermore. And He's been so good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. He's been so good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. 'Cause He picked me up and He turned me around, and He placed my feet on solid ground. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, He picked me up and He turned me around, and He placed my feet on a solid ground. Hallelujah. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. He's been so good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me. So good, so, so good to me, Jesus. God, love, joy, peace, and righteousness in the Holy Spirit. Whoa, yeah. Whoa, I've got love, joy, peace, and righteousness in the Holy Spirit. Whoa, yeah. Whoa. Holy Spirit, whoa, oh, yeah, whoa, I've got love, joy, peace, and righteousness in the Holy Spirit, whoa, oh, yeah, whoa, so good, so good to me, so good, so good to me. So good, so good to me, Jesus. He's been so good, so good to me. So good, so good to me. So good, so good to me, Jesus. So good, so good to me. So good, so good to me. So good, so good to me, Jesus.
One more time.
So good, so good to me. So good, so good to me. So good, so good to me, Jesus.
He picked me up and he turned me around and he placed my feet on solid ground. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Picked me up and he turned me around and he placed my feet on solid ground. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Father, we know that it's your kindness, it's your gentleness, it's your goodness to us that takes us to the place of repentance, that takes us to the place of surrender. We thank you, God, for everything that you have done. In light of your goodness, in light of your kindness, all complaining breaks off, all ungratefulness breaks off. We're able to see you for who you are and for what you've done in our lives. We give you glory, God. You're a good father. You're a good savior. You're a good shepherd. You're a good leader. You're a good redeemer to us, God. We thank you. We love you, Father. Keeping in mind that it's the kindness of God that leads us to repentance, we'll shift gears into praying on behalf of the Church of Korea. We'll be praying through passages of Joel 2, where God calls us to repentance, that he would be able to pour out his Spirit upon this nation. We'll begin by praying for individual repentance and corporate repentance, leading us to national revival and an ushering in for the end times harvest. Lord, may your church hear your call to repentance. Rid us of our pride, rid us of our denial. Lord, that your church would hear, have ears to hear and have eyes to see. Rid us of our hardness of heart and our rebellion. We are so prone to forget what genuine repentance is about, so prone to mindlessly obey the form, forgetting the substance. But you are the God who sees into our hearts. You're the God who reads our thoughts and our intentions. Father, release a new grace for genuine repentance, that the fear of the Lord would invade people in their prayer closets and personal times of devotion, that you would renew us a desire for holiness through the supernatural intervention of your Holy Spirit. May we never outgrow this fear of the Lord and a heart of repentance, knowing that at the other side of repentance is forgiveness. There is hope. There is deliverance. There is redemption. We thank you, God, that you leading us into repentance is your act of mercy. Let's pray. Joel 2:15 and 16, they say, blow the trumpet in Zion, declare a holy fast, call a sacred assembly. Lord, we confess that so often the church in Korea has become a place where people have come to desire respectability, outward appearances of godliness and respect. So often we have seen the church become the last place where someone would feel safe to become vulnerable and confess their sins to their leaders. We pray that through a spirit of humility, fear of the Lord, and a right understanding of the gospel of grace, would you transform your church into a safe haven for the sinner looking for change and looking for redemption. We pray that the collective fear of the Lord will begin to outweigh the fear of rejection, the fear of losing face, that the holiness and hope offered by the gospel would be so appealing that nothing would hold people back from grasping onto that hope. Make your church a place of restoration. Fill up your house with testimony after testimony of transformed and redeemed saints. Let's pray. And afterward, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see visions. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. Father, begin to stir up in our hearts a desire to see your Holy Spirit being poured out in great measure over this nation. This is a nation that is lost, that is helpless, hopeless without your intervention. Help us to begin to dream of a nation transformed by the power of your outpouring. Sons and daughters prophesying, the older generation dreaming dreams of God, the younger generation seeing visions of God. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us. May we see a nation rightly stewarding your gifts and celebrating your supernatural works in our time. Have your way in this nation, God. We surrender this nation to you. We ask, God, that you would be a God to intervene and pour out your Holy Spirit over us as we repent and come to you. Let's pray.
your spirit. Pour out your spirit on all flesh in this nation, that they may glorify you. Pour out your spirit. Oh, pour out your spirit on all flesh in this nation, and they will glorify your name. Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit on all flesh. Just
pour out
in this
your Holy Spirit. Pour out your Holy Spirit over this nation.
Your name. Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit on all flesh in this nation, that they may glorify your name. Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit on all flesh in this nation, that they may glorify you. Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit on all flesh in this nation.
Open up your heavens over this nation, God. Open up your heavens over this nation, God.
Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit on all flesh in this nation, that they may glorify your name. Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit. Pour out your spirit. Your spirit, oh God, pour out your spirit,
pour out your Holy Spirit,
pour out your spirit,
pour out your spirit,
pour out your spirit,
pour out your spirit,
oh God, pour out your spirit.
We wait for you, Holy Spirit.
Pour out your spirit.
We wait for you, Holy Spirit.
Pour out your spirit, oh God.
Joel 2:32-33, and everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. For on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there will be deliverance, as the Lord has said, among the survivors whom the Lord calls. Father, we know a glorious time is coming when we'll see your Holy Spirit moving among nations like never before. As people call upon the name above all names, as people in this nation begin to call upon the name of the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob once again, may we see mass repentance leading to mass salvations. We long to see thousands upon thousands of people being won over by the gospel message in the midst of darkness, as it was in the days of Acts. Entire cities being overturned by the preaching of your word, as in the days of the 1907 revival in Pyongyang. Prepare your church to sow into this end time harvest and to reap in abundance. Let us not miss out, Lord God, but let your church widen her nets, increase her capacity to not just evangelize, but also to disciple. May the nations hear of the great deliverance of the Lord in these end times. Let's pray. Father, in your mercy, would you awaken your church at this hour that we would not be found asleep when we're called to be in prayer. I pray, God, that you would do your sovereign work, Lord God, over this nation and over the church in this nation. Lord God, would you have your way? This is a nation, Lord God, that belongs to you. This is a church that you have ransomed through your blood. And I pray, God, that at this hour, Lord God, we would see great and mighty works at your hand. Lord God, may we see your church rising up, Lord God, not just in pride and in an influence, Lord God, but may we see repentance, Lord God, like never before. May we see hope, Lord God, for the sinner, hope for the broken, like never before. May we see you doing your amazing work here in this nation, in the church in this nation. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We pray these things in your name. Amen.
And all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. And all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. And all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. And all the earth, and all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. Yeah.
thank you, Lord. Thank you for repositioning our hearts to revere you, to fear you, to praise you, because you're worthy. You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, Jesus. You're worthy to receive all that you died for. We pray, Lord, that you would receive your inheritance in Korea, in this nation, in this peninsula. That you would reawaken us, that you would reawaken the church. Lord, we ask that all that you did in the past, God, in the, with our forefathers, would you do it again? Would you do it again, Lord? We want to see mass repentance. We want to see mass revival. We want to see salvation. We want to see the youth. We want to see the young and the old praising you, walking in the fullness of the destiny that you have for them. And we thank you, God, that we get to partner with you, God. We thank you, Lord, that you give us just a glimpse of your heart more and more each day. We love you, Jesus. We pray all these things in your name. Amen. Thanks for joining us this morning. I hope that you are blessed by the powerful presence of the Lord, and that, that he really spoke to you. We invite you to come out again tomorrow. We have a watch at 8 o'clock p.m. And, please come back next week and join us. Have a good day.